The figures look promising. At the end of January, there were 50 patients in the 8 centres MSF runs in Liberia, Guinea and Sierra Leone. But complacency would be disastrous. The drop in the number of cases is the opportunity for the teams to focus on breaking the chain of Ebola transmission and to provide their patients with the best possible care. MSF has decided to open a maternity unit in its Ebola treatment centre in the Freetown suburb, Kisii, to deliver specialist care to pregnant women infected with the virus.
When a pregnant woman contracts Ebola, she has many more chances than other pregnant women to miscarriage or to have a complication associated to her delivery. So they require specialized care as many as any other pregnant woman, and they require this to be done in a setting that ensures infection control measures that will avoid transmission to the staff.
One such patient is Adama, admitted to the center in Kisii. She lost the baby she was carrying, but she did survive Ebola.
She's going to be discharged today. She's cured. So we're going in to do her discharge shower so that even though she's not infectious, maybe some of the items that have been in the confirmed tent are. So we're going to do a shower to disinfect everything, give her new clothes, and then she'll be able to walk out as a cured patient.
After spending several weeks at the centre, it's now time for Adama to leave. Before taking her back to her family, the MSF team offers her psychological support. Until now, not much was known about the disease, and even less when it's contracted during pregnancy. Doctors have treated a large number of cases during the epidemic, and they've seen that while the chances of a fetus surviving are virtually non-existent, they can help mothers. The water is beginning to recede, but the South Malawi plains are still waterlogged. Some very low-lying areas look more like islands and can only be reached by helicopter. Burita was 8 months pregnant when water started rising up around the village of Makanga. She gave birth just a few days later.
We went to Makanga Clinic, but it was closed. There was no one there to help. I was told to wait. I was told that a helicopter was coming, that it could take me to another clinic. Fortunately, when the helicopter arrived, it brought with it someone from MSF to help us.
Flooding such as this can trigger epidemics, especially measles and malaria. 20,000 people remain cut off from the rest of the country, so MSF is scouring the region by helicopter to provide them with medical care and distribute medical supplies. These MSF workers are preparing to distribute medical supplies to hospitals in East Ukraine. Constantly changing destination and working on both sides of the front line, they provide assistance to health facilities frequently lacking even the most basic supplies.
So far, we have provided this kind of kits in 70 hospitals in both sides of the conflict. We have treated, this material is enough to treat around 15,000 people.
This support enables hospitals to continue to deliver treatment to people wounded in the conflict, as well as to the chronically sick and expectant mothers. But the bombing is hampering their work and denying thousands of people access to medical care. In just 2 weeks, 5 facilities supported by MSF have been damaged or totally destroyed by rockets or mortar shells.